How many of you went to school with a girl that was pregnant? And how many of you felt like the minority because you actually did not have a kid? See, this is a problem with Kalamazoo and the United States in general. Even though the teen pregnancies have been declining, we still feel this impact in our day-to-day lives. So I've conducted a lot of research, and I want to talk to you today about teen pregnancy issues in Kalamazoo. I want to talk about pregnancy prevention ideas and also costs of teen pregnancy. So according to Nancy Duringer, August 9th of 2012 from EMLA, she actually said that 39.7 of 1,000 girls ages 15 to 19 gives birth in the United States, which is crazy in comparison to other countries because in Canada it's 14.2, the UK is 25, and Australia is 16.5. And Michigan alone is 32.7. So you can really see the impact on what's going on in Michigan. But to relate it to back to Kalamazoo, I'm going to talk about one of the local high schools. It's called Loy Norix. And they actually have a child daycare center in their college or in their high school for not only the students for their kids to go to, but also for staff and open public. So really seeing that all of the, like, the Kalamazoo and the public schools are actually having that, it really drives it home that this is a problem. And hopefully Kalamazoo will start implementing pregnancy prevention techniques. Which brings me to my next subject of the pregnancy prevention techniques. According to New York Times on October 4th of 2012, they did a study in St. Louis, which it actually was 9,000 women. They were following them around. They were actually giving them free contraceptive options. So they were giving them the permanent ones like IUDs, which can stay in for 5 to 10 years, but also birth control pills and patches and shots. And when they came back 2 years later to the study, they found out that only 6.3 out of 1,000 teens were actually getting pregnant, which is crazy because the national average was 34 out of 1,000. So it really shows what a pregnancy prevention technique can really help. The next one I want to talk about is from Jackson County. And according to Terrell Jackson, February 17th of 2012 from MLive, Jackson County actually was given $600,000 in grants to what they did was they talked to high-risk children, high-risk teens, and they were able to stress how important self-images are, how important life management skills are, achieving goals, and critical thinking. So they put a lot of the money in being able to build their self-esteem, which really helped out a lot because they actually dropped from 69 to 60.3 out of 1,000. And then the last one I want to talk about for the pregnancy preventions actually was from Terrell Jackson, or from Nancy Duringer, August 9th, 2012 from MLive, and it was about Katherine Ferguson Academy. This school is for females that have had kids or they're going to have kids. So they are actually able to bring their kids into the school and they teach them not only the high school curriculum, but they also teach them parenting techniques, so then they're able to be more effective parents as well. But I feel like the most like amazing thing that happens from this school is in order for you to graduate, you have to have applied to a 2 or 4 year college and be accepted. So this really shows them that they have other alternatives rather than just being a single parent. So I feel like having this, that you can be in college, will really give them a beneficial idea. And most of us are broke college students, right? So hopefully this next one will really bring this home as well. Taxes. For teen-bearing children in Michigan, it costs taxpayers $308 million, and that's actually $9 billion in the United States. So if you think back to the Jackson County example when they had $600,000 and they implemented that and they had such a big change, I feel like if we were to use some of this money in order to implement it in pregnancy prevention techniques in Kalamazoo, it'll really help everything. And then for the last one that I want to talk about, it's about from birth to 17 years old, the cost of a child is actually $295,560, according to Bonnie Kovasi from the Huffington Post on July 26th. So you can really see how expensive a child is, and hopefully you'll make smarter decisions for the next one. So I'll leave us with a few quotes. Don't be a fool, wrap your tool. Don't be silly, protect your willy. And my personal favorite, if you can't shield your rocket, leave it in your pocket. So from Loy Norix to the cost of pregnancies, we've talked about a lot of topics today. So hopefully you've all learned about teen pregnancy issues within Kalamazoo. You've learned about different pregnancy prevention techniques and the cost of the pregnancies. So before you get knocked up or get someone knocked up, are you ready to spend $295,560 versus $10 on a box of condoms? Mm-hmm. Thank you.